This is a bearded dragon, and without UVB light, Diamond here would die a horrible death. But just because he needs it doesn't mean that all reptiles do. And today we're going to go over the top 5 reptiles that thrive without UVB light. My name's Adam, this is Diamond, you're watching Wicked's Wicked Reptiles, stick around. UVB light is important for many species of reptiles, and if your reptile needs it, you need to give it to them. You cannot cheap out whatsoever. But just because some reptiles need it doesn't mean that all of them do. And today we're going over reptiles that not survive, but thrive, live a perfectly healthy life, as healthy as if they had UVB without it. So with that, let's just get started. Oh, before we do, if you're new to the hobby or you don't know what UVB is, basically it's a spectrum of light that comes from the sun, UVA, UVB, anyway, I won't get too sciencey about it. Basically, UVB helps a lot of different reptiles synthesize calcium, so their bones will be very weak, brittle, deformed without it. There's many other things UVB does, but basically certain animals need it or they'll die terrible deaths. Okay, let's get into it. Number 5, sand boas. Now we'll talk mostly about Kenyan sand boas because they are the most common by far. These animals do just fine with no UVB at all. Now most snakes do. As far as I can tell, there's really no species of snake that we know a lot about that will die and have a terrible life without UVB, like a bearded dragon would, for example. Now this doesn't mean that some snakes don't benefit from it, or maybe all snakes do. It's really up in the air. There's a lot of new research being done. For example, garter snakes are seen basking all the time, and I think they do great with UVB. I think hognose snakes, okay, this is about sand boas. Get to it. Well, sand boas are gonna spend most of their life buried beneath sand. Now, this doesn't mean they wouldn't use UVB if they had the opportunity. So if you have a sand boa, I mean, by all means, throw it in there. But these guys, which are basically 2-foot, very tiny little boas, they're gonna spend their life buried. They are fossorial animals, so they're not going to see the light of day for most of the time in the wild and in captivity. This doesn't mean they won't be out and about cruising every once in a while, but generally, as a general rule, you're gonna find them. Well, basically, you have a pet sandbox if you have a pet sand boa. Now, I don't mean to poop on sand boas. I think they're awesome. They're maybe one of the most beautiful snakes that there is, period. And there's a bunch of different morphs as well. Something very cool about sand boas is they strike sideways. A lot of other snakes, they'll kind of coil back and do this kind of spring-like thing, and then they'll lunge forward, where sand boas often strike to the sides, which I think is really, really cool. Also, they're great eaters. If they're beneath the sand, you don't see where they are, you can take a mouse on tongs and just kind of wave it around, and then eventually, bam, a little head will bam. What kind of sound is bam? Bam!
Bam!
A little head will pop out and that your mouse is gone from your tongs. Sand boas are actually really cool. I personally don't have any interest in owning one myself, just simply because I like animals that are out and about and you can walk in your reptile room when they're there. But these guys can be pretty handleable and I think they make really great pets, and they actually would work for a starter pet too. So if you want something small, these guys are a great animal. And as the list implies, they do just fine without UVB, as good as if you would give it to them, according to the studies we have available to us now. Number 4, a channel favorite, Chinese cave geckos. I love Chinese cave geckos. They're kind of like other types of geckos that are terrestrial, although these guys, if I had to guess, would be not semi-arboreal, but you'd find them up on rocks, rock faces, things like that, because they can do things like this with their feet. So they are similar definitely to other species like leopard geckos and African fat-tailed geckos that look similar, have the functioning eyelids, things like that. They have a similar diet as well because they are completely insectivores, so no salads for these guys. I mean, Diamond wishes he was a cave gecko, I bet. I think he can hear the cricket, which is why he's being all crazy. Anyway, these animals are found in and around caves, and they are nocturnal. Some people would say crepuscular, but generally, I would call them nocturnal in my own estimation by what I've seen, by what I've observed with them. I have 3 of them. I never see them out except for in the middle of the night. If I go downstairs at 2 or 3 in the morning, and I look in their enclosure, what are you doing? I will see them out and cruising. If I'm out at 5 in the morning or 6, right before the sun comes up, I don't see them out at all. So these guys are definitely fine without a UVB light. I will stand behind that completely. I think that they're amazing pets though, because they are great to handle. They have really cool faces. They have cool attitudes. They're easy to take care of. They're small, so they don't need giant enclosures. You could probably put a pair of these in a 40-gallon enclosure and call it a day. Make a cool rock background on there so they can climb up it, feed them their insects. Wham, bam, Bob's your uncle. You have a happy animal, and you don't need special lighting. Just a day-night cycle. This is a species I've never tried to put a UVB light on, but because I am making a enclosure that is a custom-built background and it's a custom enclosure, I'm gonna try it just to see if it makes any difference. I always recommend experimenting within reason and doing your research first to make sure your experiment won't hurt your animals. I'll give it a try and report back. So hit subscribe if you haven't already, because I love updating what I've learned about reptiles. So follow along. Number three, and it wouldn't be a WWR list if I didn't ruin it with an amphibian, axolotls. Now, I speak about axolotls infrequently. I think these are very underrated if you want an animal that you'll never touch. Just no touchy.
No touchy.
With axolotls. These guys, they need a cool water temperature. Now, they don't really need any special lighting. They need a day-night cycle. You can put a light on top of their enclosure like we do during the day, but this is just for like showing them off. Usually, they have an ambient light where I live anyway, just in my setup, my collection, because it stresses them out. Axolotls will curve their gills around when they're stressed, and they'll kind of curve their tails. There's a bunch of telltale signs. There's an axolotl video right here if you want to learn more. And with these guys, the light seems to stress them out. Not just because I read a care guide and it said so, but because of people that I speak to and my own axolotls that I see. If I have the light on for too long, they seem to be stressed. Just in my personal research, I don't think it'd be a great idea because light in general that is too bright kind of stresses them out. And you do need a UVB light to be within a certain range for that UVB to be transmitted to the animal anyway. So of all the animals, I think these guys probably wouldn't be the best candidate. But again, I'm not against experimentation, and do your own research and do your own experiments if they're safe. And of course, it is less common for amphibians to need UVB than certain types of reptiles, even if they're diurnal. So that's another video completely. I don't really want to spend a lot of time on axolotls because, I mean, they're cute and everything, but oh yeah, and they eat bugs like this. They're actually kind of adorable. I could spend all day, so I won't. Let's just move on. Number two. Blind snakes. Now, these aren't the best pets for most people. I just think that if you want a snake that you're not gonna see a lot and you don't want a sand boa and you want something even smaller, then a blind snake might actually work for you. My big gripe with them is although they're kind of easy to take care of in captivity and they generally do pretty well, they're almost always not captive bred. They're almost always found in things like flower pots, which is why they're called flower pot snakes in a lot of parts of the world. In fact, I sold plants and flowers professionally for 6 years. I worked at a distributor, and we found these guys in pots from Florida before. They are extremely invasive. They're not originally from places like Florida, but you find them there in a lot of places in North America. These guys, they'll eat things like, well, slug bits and worm bits and even worm feces. So feeding them isn't much of a challenge. Throw a bunch of worms and slugs in there and let nature take its course. Now, I did some research about these guys for a previous video, which you can watch right here. But since then, some people who have had them in captivity and keep them as pets have come up to me and messaged me and told me about their experience. And they turn out to be actually much better pets than I thought. Now, these guys do not need UVB at all. They're fossorial. You're gonna find them under the substrate most of the time. 100%, I am confident from the research that is available to us now, these guys live a perfectly healthy life without UVB as good as if they had it. Now, of course, I keep saying that. If these things change, I will update because I'm not afraid to admit when I am wrong or the sources are wrong. But as far as I can tell, if you want an animal that is pretty small, that is a snake, that doesn't eat rodents, that doesn't need UVB, I mean, these guys kind of take the cake. As long as you're okay with an animal that only gets to like 6 inches long. Like, I'm talking really small snakes. And number one, the best pet reptile that doesn't need UVB and thrives without it, spotted pythons. Or Stimson's pythons, which actually the same thing now. Or children's pythons, or pygmy pythons. It doesn't really matter. They're all part of the same family. Antaresia, are you going back home now? You gonna go catch that cricket? All right, peace out, Girl Scout.
Diamond's a boy.
These guys do fantastic in captivity. I think these are probably the most underrated, well, between them and Doomerl's boas, which also do really well without UVB, by the way. I mean, I think they're the most underrated snake that there is. They're only about 4 feet, although a friend of mine showed me a 6-foot specimen, which is a monster, but generally 4 feet. And spotteds are the largest of the smallest genus of pythons in the world. So pygmy pythons, if you want those instead, they're the smallest python in the entire world. These guys are from Australia, and they come in, well, basically one pattern and morph. If you're from Australia, you'll find variations, but otherwise, these guys, this is kind of how they look. They are amazing eaters. I love my spotted python, Jimmy. He's a great guy. He's fun to handle. He's fantastic. He's actually eating a mouse right now, which is why I'm not handling him for this video. I always decide to shoot these on feeding day. So silly. Anyway, I love handling him. I love taking him out. He's very inquisitive. He kind of moves around. Someone told me they move around like scrub pythons, which I never thought of before, but they are semi-arboreal and they are kind of a slender snake in comparison to, I mean, their length. They don't get big around like, say, a ball python or a blood python for a bigger example. So I think these guys are underrated. They're amazing. They do fine without UVB. They are a crepuscular type species. I love them. You're gonna see them more common in the hobby. You're gonna see a really cool setup I'm making for mine. Spotted pythons are the bomb. So there you go. Those are your top 5 awesome pet reptiles that thrive without UVB. Again, make sure you give UVB to all the animals that actually need it for sure. And it generally almost always is a good idea to provide it for enrichment for other animals too. So I'm not anti-UVB, I just know some of you aren't gonna provide it, and these are the best animals for you, in my opinion. What do you think? I know UVB is a hot topic, there's certain channels that make UVB their entire personalities. Let me know in the comment section below what you think about it, and if you want, drop an idea down there for a future video, that's where I get all my ideas from. And thank you so much for hitting subscribe, for hitting like. It costs you nothing, but it helps this channel immensely. And a special thank you to the Patreon supporters. You guys are freaking amazing. You get videos early. You know about the dream reptile that I finally got last week. I am so happy. I can't wait to share it with you, but it's on Patreon right now if you want to see it early, just like some of the videos, discounts on the merch, and things like that. For as little as $1 a month, you can be a Patreon supporter too. I'd appreciate it. And so would Diamond, who is actually sitting on my notebook right now, which you can see that picture on Instagram. Okay, I've plugged absolutely everything. Because I do videos twice a week, that means I'll see you on Monday. No, I'll see you on Thursday, because today is, okay, see you on Thursday.